Hi, I'm Helle. Today I will explain the basic rules for Bad Bones. And this is a competitive version of the game where we will all try to protect our tower and our village. First we will take a look at the setup for the game and then I will explain the rules. These skeletons with the orange border you will not use in the basic version of the game. You can put them back into the box. For the basic game you will need all these 180 skeletons. You will take all these and put into the bag. Each player will receive a player board, where there is room for one tower in the center. And you will receive 4 tower levels and place them at the center of your board. And you will receive 1 hero and you will place your hero on top of the tower. At the bottom of your board, where there aren't any forest, you will receive 5 houses. This is your village. And each player will receive 6 traps, 2 walls, 2 catapults, 1 dragon and a treasure. And on top of your board you will place your cemetery. Every player will now draw 4 skeletons from the bag. And each skeleton they have this colored symbol and you will place them at that symbol walking in the right direction. Not walking like this or on their head, but like this. So you will place them like that. And this one here. And one here and one here. So your board will start with 4 skeletons. If you draw a skeleton with this red symbol, then you will return it to the bag and draw a new one. At the start, you will not start with a skeleton on these red symbols. So this is the setup for all players. They will have their own board, their own village and tower to protect. Place this player 8 board at the center of the table. And you will take this token and place on the first space with the white side showing in the first round. And here we have the setup of the game. I have set up 4 players, so we can only see the top, the cemetery for the other players. But they would have a board that looked like this. And then you have the player 8 with all the turns, so we can remember the 4 steps we have to go through in each turn. And we have our skeletons in this bag. All players will do these actions simultaneously. And each round consists of 4 phases. In the first phase, all players they have to move their hero. And after all players have moved their hero 1 space, we will go to the second phase. And here, each player they can place a trap, retrieve a trap, or do nothing. And when all players have done this, we will go to the third phase, flip this marker over, and we have to move all of our skeletons 1 space and flip them to the dark side. When all players have done this, we will go to the fourth phase, and here each player will draw 3 new skeletons from the bag, and if some of your friendly neighbors they have placed some skeletons at your cemetery, you have to take them and place all of these new skeletons to your board. Now let's take a closer look at all the phases. The first action is move your hero 1 space. And you have to move your hero 1 space. You can't let him be where he is. So I could move my hero to any of these spaces. So I might move him down there. If you move your hero into a space with skeletons, then all skeletons will be killed and returned to the bag. If a skeleton moves into your hero's space, then it will be killed and put back into the bag. If one or more skeletons moves into the space with the hero when he is standing on top of the tower, he does not kill these skeletons. They will destroy a level of the tower. Your hero may stay on your different traps and he will protect your trap when he is standing here. So if any skeletons moves onto the space, the trap will not trigger. You will just fight them and put them back into the bag. So you can use your hero to protect your traps on the board. After all players have moved their hero 1 space, we will go to the second phase. Here we can place a trap or we can take a trap back from our board. Only 1 trap can be placed or you can take 1 back. You can't do both. When you have to place your traps, you have to place them on an empty space. Or if you place the dragon, you may place them on skeletons. You can also place them underneath your hero. But other than that, they have to be placed on an empty space. You cannot place them on your tower or on another trap or on the skeletons, except for the dragon. And we have these four different types of traps. The wall can be used to direct the skeletons in another direction. So if I would use this wall, I could put it here. And instead of this skeleton going this way, it would follow the wall and turn 90 degrees and go this way. So here we could put one that way, and the other one would go this way. After you have moved all the skeletons, then you will turn over the trap to the other side. It has now been a bit destroyed. And you can use this one more time, but if there are any skeletons going into this space and it has this red cross, then you would remove it from the game and you would then lose it. So the second time skeletons enters this, you will lose it. You can, instead of placing a trap, then you can take it back and then you have it again and can use it again. This catapult, when you place this and skeletons enters it, then you will take all the skeletons and you will turn this over and you will send them over to one of the other players. And you can choose whomever you want to send them over to. It can be this player or this player. And you cannot divide them. You have to take all of them and place to the same player. And if this is entered a second time, then it is removed from the game. The dragon is scary. All the skeletons, they want to run away when they see the dragon. So if these enter this space, you may decide where to turn them to. So you could make this one run away this way, and maybe this way, and this way. You wouldn't want to send them down towards your houses. And when it's used, you will turn it over. You can also place the dragon in a space where there is skeletons. So I could place it here. And then I would immediately turn it to this side and I would decide where to send these skeletons. So I might send them like this and then it will be turned over. And the next time a skeleton enters this space, you will lose the dragon. And this treasure tile, it starts with a cross on it. This means that if any skeletons enters this, you will lose the treasure. They will steal your treasure. You can place your hero on top of this space and he will protect the treasure. So the skeletons would die if they entered this space with your hero on top of it. When you place this treasure, then all skeletons standing in this space will turn towards the treasure. When these skeletons enter the treasure, these skeletons will now steal the treasure and they will keep moving in the direction they faced when they entered this space. And this skeleton, if he at the same turn moved here, he would turn towards the treasure. And then you would steal the treasure away because of these. If your hero is protecting the treasure and these skeletons move into the treasure, then he is protecting the treasure and these skeletons are removed. After all players, they have either placed a trap, retrieved a trap or done nothing, then we will go to the third phase and we will flip over this token to the dark side. And now we have to move all of our skeletons one space and we have to flip them to the other side. And when we move the skeletons, if any skeletons move out of these borders into the forest, then all that will move out this way will go to our neighbor on our right. All that will go out this way will go out to our neighbor on our left. And all of the skeletons that move into the forest at the top of our border, we can decide where to place them, on which cemetery for our opponents we want to place the skeletons. If anyone enters down here, then we will lose a house for each skeleton. And if anyone enters our tower, we will lose one level for each skeleton. But let's start moving them all. This one will enter this space and destroy one house. You can turn over any of the houses. And this one will be discarded. This one will move this way. And when you move into an arrow from the side, you will turn in the arrow's direction. So this will turn this way. This skeleton will move out into the forest and go over to our neighbor. So we will put him on our neighbor's cemetery. This one will move down a space. And this one will move into our hero and he will be killed. So you will discard him. These two will enter this catapult. And this one will also enter this catapult. And we will have to flip it over. It has been used one time. And now we can choose which opponent we want to send these skeletons to. We cannot split them up and send one here and here. We have to, when we use the catapult, to send them to the same player. So we might send him to the opponent on the opposite of us. And this skeleton will move into our tower and we will lose one level of our tower. This skeleton will move in here and be turned towards our tower. And when you move against the arrows, you will not turn your skeleton. He will just move in here. These two will move down here. This one will move up here and I can place him wherever I want to. And I might think he needs to have some skeletons too. And this one will go this way and this one will go this way because of the wall. And he will join our neighbor to the right. And I can choose where to place him. I think we will place him over here. And because of this red cross is the second time this wall has been used, then it will be discarded. After the third phase, all players have moved all of their skeletons, then we will go to the fourth phase. And here we all players will draw three new skeletons from the bag. And we will take the skeletons from our cemetery and place them all to our board. Here. And oh, a lot of them from the top here. So in the next round, we know where the skeletons they will arrive from. And we will go back to the start and play exactly the same way. Until one player has lost their last tower or their last house, then we would go to end scoring. After one or more players has lost their last tower or their last house, then the game will end. And all players that have a house and at least one tower will count up their score. Not the players that have lost all their houses or towers. They have lost the game. And we will count all of our stars on all of our traps and our houses. And each tower level we have left is worth 4 points. So this player will have 3, 5, 7, 8, plus 6, 14, plus 4 for each tower level, it would be 18 points. And the player with the most points will be the winner of the game. And if there is a tie between players, then the player with the tallest tower will win the game. And if there is still a tie, then they will share victory. And that was a look at the rules for the basic version of the game. You can also play the game in a solo version where we'll use the other side of the board and you will have an amount of turns you have to survive in. The game can also be played in an advanced mode. The game also comes with a cooperative version where you can work together. You will use the other side of the board where you can use 4 towers, one on each space. You will have traps you share and you have the same village you have to protect. And you can also play the game with these skeleton chiefs with the orange border that would add even more to the game. And that was my explanation of the rules for the basic version of Bad Bones. Thanks for watching.